It's Sunday, September 11th, 2016, and it's 8:45 a.m. Time for another Comics and Coffee. What's up, everybody? I'm Stan, and welcome to Detail Comics, where we go over comics in detail. And today is another episode of Comics and Coffee, which is my weekly live show, unedited, really, where I go over a few topics regarding the comic book industry and things like that, and kind of give you a little bit of an idea of what's going on, what's going to be coming up on the channel. So, you know, it's a great way for me to communicate with you guys as far as the community is kind of hopefully going to grow around this channel itself. And what I really wanted to touch base on is the fact that today is the 15-year anniversary of the 9/11 attacks. So it's one of those things where there's a whole lot of politicization. Politicalization around those. Sorry, not quite up to snuff. But really, what it comes down to is it's important to remember what happened specifically on that day. Like right now, I can remember very vividly. I was sitting inside the senior lounge at my high school. I had a second period study hall, and ultimately, because I was on high honors, National Honor Society, I didn't have to go to any of my study halls, so I could go wherever I wanted. Cool perk, right? So basically we were sitting there, we were having a normal conversation, and the next thing I know, one of our science teachers was walking down the hallway and he goes, "You guys need to get to the library. History is being made." So a group of us went down to the library. We listened in on the radio, and there were probably already 7 or 8 students huddled around this AM/FM radio because there wasn't a TV in the library, and we listened to everything unfold on Ground Zero. We heard the second plane hit. And when the towers fell, we heard those things. And that really marked the entire day, the entire rest of, basically the rest of America was defined by that moment and our response to it. So I'm not saying whether our response is yay or nay, I don't really care about that. It's just ultimately showing the respect for the people, that lost their lives on that day, and those first responders that went in, that ran in the face of danger while people were running away. They ran towards it, knowing that they could help out their fellow man. And that was that's huge. It's a huge thing to go above yourself in the pursuit of helping someone else that you might not even know. And it's funny because like the comics industry, they take into account. You think about all these world-ending kind of events and whatnot. But, here's a good example. So, like, this is Amazing Spider-Man Volume 2, Number 36. So this is the 9/11 commemorative kind of cover, which is one of those things where, comic books, they take into account things that happen in real life, and it's much more apparent in something like Marvel, where it's set in the real world. It's set in New York City. So if you're telling a story and you're providing the art and something drastic happens to the skyline of one of your major places, it's going to have an impact. It's going to ripple across the entirety of the industry and the universe within that. And there's no way you can't pay attention to those kind of world-shaking things. So, it's one of those things where comics and society have been intrinsically linked. When we became much more war involved back in the 40s and things like that, and there was the Cold War, there was a big transition from superhero comics to more war-oriented comics. And then when war kind of, fell out of favor going in towards like Vietnam, there was a bit much bigger pullback, and then it was all about social injustice. And that's why the rise of the mutants was so popular, is because it basically was a personification of what was going on with women's rights, with African-American rights. The civil rights movement was personified in the struggles of characters like the X-Men, the introduction of black superheroes, and the legitimization of female superheroes, turning them into something beyond just a damsel in distress. Like the comics book industry itself has been very tied into changes in social awareness and culture. And that's just another example of how something that happened 15 years ago that was very poignant in the history of Americans was reflected, very plainly from a publisher like Marvel or someone like that. So I just wanted to remember those kind of things. It seems so removed. There are kids in high school that will learn of what happened on 9/11 is history, in their lessons. So it's very odd. Having that kind of feel, they won't remember it actually happening. So that's pretty weird. I also I had a loss in my family, but I'm dealing with that pretty well. And overall, it's given me a few very good ideas for stories, because I'm gonna kind of pursue my goal of scripting and writing and getting into comic books and kind of things like that a lot more heavily now. Because the person that I lost, she was a very avid reader. She many novels, used to run a library. She was great, a very intelligent woman. My grandmother was, and she was a very hard lady, different generation, but ultimately very intelligent, very much a reader. And I feel like, moving in the form of being creative and publishing something, that'd be a cool homage to someone like that, that was so invested in books and literature and those kind of things. So I think that that's going to be a really cool kind of, not necessarily a task of mine to do, but it's good motivation. You got to take the good out of bad situations. So ultimately, things that are coming up from the channel, because wow, super Debbie Downer on this one. Let me just kind of perk this up a bit, I guess. DC Rebirth introduction titles are coming to a close, so I'm probably going to do a video with my top 10 DC Rebirth titles so far in order, so that way I can really go over what's I feel is good, what I feel is worth following in terms of DC Rebirth. Again, that's a very personal opinion of mine, but I wanted to kind of share it with you guys. I'm going to give probably do a video on my most anticipated new titles from the Marvel Now 2.0 launch, which is going to start next month. So you should be seeing that coming out soon. I'm also going to want to do a few, like, getting into comics, getting into collecting kind of things. And then a few kind of, I'm going to try out a few different video formats, see how I can present the information and whether they're interesting to you guys. So let me know, hit the likes, hit the subscribes, give me the thumbs up, hit me up in the comments, so that way you can let me know what you think of those new videos. As for right now, I'm going to start getting everything prepared. I do have a very random work day today, so I'm working from 12 until 5. So that means that I'm not necessarily going to be able to get everything that I want done today, but I will get a lot done. So I'm going to start prepping everything for this coming week, so that way I can film and hopefully get all those videos out on time for you guys. There is a little bit of time between now and the service, and I don't really see it impacting those kind of things, but I hope you can understand if it does. So, as always, this has been another episode of Comics and Coffee. Thanks for sticking with me, and making it past that whole first intro part. As always, if you like what you see, hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe if you want more news, reviews, and commentary on comic books, comic book movies, TV shows, games, and anything and everything inside the world of comics.